What's up, everybody? This is Candy.
And this is B, and this is a Trend Kill Quickie.
We're going to say this one's going to be a 10-minute one because there's a lot going on here. So
talk about to hold on to your seats. Going for a ride.
So without further ado, we have a little story for you today regarding essentially Alice Cooper versus Gene Simmons with a little Paul Stanley kiss in there. Back in 2014, Gene Simmons started this whole thing by making this bold statement that rock is dead. A lot of artists are speaking out against his opinion.
And, you know, some of the reasons he blames a lack of enthusiasm among the youth of today as one of the main culprits. You know, these goddamn kids.
Fucking teenagers.
He also feels the monetary model of streaming services has really done away with a lot of mainstream rock music. Because, quote, when you download stuff, it's 100th or 1,000th of one penny, and musicians can no longer earn a real living off of actually making music. Now, I don't know the actual logistics if that's actually a fact. Is it really?
It is a fact.
He also feels musicians these days just don't play their own instruments anymore. He says people rely a lot on electronics to create music, which I personally don't think is necessarily a bad thing, because we love a lot of artists that use a lot of electronics in their music. But he says that, like, just people don't write their own music anymore. They don't play their own instruments. They don't know what the hell they're doing. So he thinks that's why rock and roll has just become so absent from the mainstream.
And yeah, that was one thing I do remember him saying, is that he just believes that the lack of rock and roll in the mainstream is what's really killing rock and roll, and the fact that it's not really aired on TV. And I mean, he has like this laundry list of reasons that he's went over in several interviews over the course of several years now, why he thinks rock music's dead. So in some ways, I kind of can agree with some of his beliefs.
I can too, for sure.
But one thing that he says that like kind of bothers me is that he believes that from 1958 to 1988 was the height of rock and roll, and that he attributes the Beatles a lot for some reason, which I think is kind of weird, but whatever. I mean, you know, he does go on to say in a lot of these interviews, you know, various bands, various artists that he respects, like Dave Grohl and the Foo Fighters, Lady Gaga even. He's a big fan of Billie Eilish. He attributes Metallica, Iron Maiden, things like that, because these people have had these long careers that are still outstanding. But he says that rock music basically died in 1988.
That's debatable.
I 100% agree that that's debatable, because you have grunge music that came out in the 90s that was huge in the mainstream still. Mm-hmm. Well, yes, I do agree that, you know, rock music is a little bit more lacking in the mainstream now.
Even nu metal in the late 90s, early 2000s. They had a huge rock presence, and that was so in the mainstream. So I don't know about 88, but I do agree that after 88, maybe it did kind of take a back seat to other things, especially pop became so big in the 90s with all of like the boy bands and things like that.
And he even mentions NSYNC, and thinking that, you know, oh yeah, NSYNC, you know, they sell out crowds and they had this massive success, but he says they ain't no Beatles. And that's a direct quote, which,
yeah,
such an old crotchety man thing.
Get off my lawn.
You know,
I think he compared NSYNC to like sugar. So like you taste sugar, tastes good, you get a rush, you get a sugar high.
Oh yeah.
And then he also said, down, and then that's it.
And he also said that like the girls that liked that kind of music eventually are just gonna get sick of it, or they're gonna get old and get sick of it.
Okay, boomer.
And I'm like,
Andy, have we gotten sick of it?
Right? I'm 33 years old and I still fucking was just listening to NSYNC today in my car. Not gonna lie.
It ain't no lie, baby. Bye, bye, bye.
And so I have the utmost respect for Gene Simmons and Kiss. I'm not a huge Kiss fan, but I have the utmost respect for them. So yeah, Kiss actually did recently streaming a show for New Year's Eve 2020. It was called the Kiss 2020 Goodbye live stream.
Yeah.
They actually broke two world records when they did this show. One for the highest flame projection in a music concert, and for the most flame projections launched simultaneously in a music concert.
Simultaneously! And there were 73 simultaneous.
That was actually another thing too that Gene Simmons had mentioned, is that he believes that today's rock musicians, they don't have enough flash and flair at their shows, which I know is a fallacy for a fact, because I've been to the most recent Smashing Pumpkins tour, and while the music was a little lacking, the production was not. They had like these 150 foot tall blow up dolls spinning around, and like their faces were changing and like their outfits were changing, and like, tell me that's not production just because they don't have fire.
Yeah, not everybody's gonna have fire, bro. I mean, you know what happened.
Rammstein.
But someone's got their face blown off. So some people are a little worried about liability and about having like fire and flame at their show. So, but very recently, just within the last week, an interview was done with the legend himself, Alice Cooper.
Not worthy. We're not worthy. We're scum.
He insists that Gene is just wrong about his assertion. And he does have a funny quote. He says, I would like him to do my taxes because he's a businessman and business-wise valid. Basically saying that when he comes to talking about rock and roll, he's not saying the right thing. He continues to believe that kids across the world are in their garages still playing riffs that, you know, Slash used to play in Guns N' Roses or Joe Perry played in Aerosmith. And he thinks that rock sort of still embodies that outlaw kind of attitude, which is like the origins of rock and roll. It wasn't in the mainstream when it got going decades ago. And he thinks everything's just kind of cyclical and that's where rock is right now. And he thinks it's exactly where it should be right now. That is just kind of underground and just waiting for the right time to burst back out into the mainstream.
And I couldn't agree more with Alice Cooper on that fact. I mean, we've seen with Suspect 208, two of our biggest stories we've ever done on Suspect 208, obviously.
Suspect 208 will interview you if you come to Cleveland. Don't forget us.
Yeah, don't forget us, please, because we love you guys. And, you know, these are kids. I mean, we're talking kids from the ages of 17 to 23 who are pushing hard rock music back into the mainstream. And then MGK, too, as well. I mean, I know everybody, a lot of people are just in MGK and his pop punk album. But you know what? It was a fucking sold out album. So go fuck yourselves.
There's some bangers on that album.
There's a couple of songs in my regular rotation now that I really just, I fucking love. And I'm not an MGK fan. I never was. So, and Post Malone's done crossovers with Ozzy Osbourne. You know, there's a lot of clashing of genres and there's a lot of people who are still doing those tributes to rock and roll and bringing rock and roll back into the mainstream. It's just maybe a little bit of a slower process.
And all those collaborations are actually sort of further proof because Alice Cooper himself even said that rock is like in the root of all of these different genres of music that have evolved from the origins of rock over these last few decades. And all of these collaborations and crossovers is just pretty much proving that.
And obviously many other artists have also spoken out against Gene Simmons' opinion, but his actual bandmate, Paul Stanley, in a recent interview also spoke out against his opinion. And this is a brand new fucking article that just came out like yesterday. But I'm just going to read a little bit of the quote here. I'm not going to necessarily read all of it just because it is kind of long. But Paul Stanley goes on to say, quote, I don't think that music can ever be dead. I don't think that bands can be dead. Rock can be dead, with a comma there. It just takes somebody to reignite it to the level it has been at some point in the past. He goes on to say he compares rock music to somebody lying on the floor unconscious. Their pulse may be faint, but all it takes is the right equipment, the right tools to bring that pulse back. And that pulse can come back stronger than ever. And I absolutely fucking love what he says there. The fact that rock can never be dead, because it's not. It's not dead. It's been taken back from the mainstream a little bit, but it's not dead. It's never been dead.
It's still very much there. Just because we don't hear about it or know about it, you know, the mainstream doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
Right.
It does not exist. The limit does not exist.
I absolutely agree with Paul Stanley there. The rock music's not dead. It will come back. It's just going to be a matter of timing.
Timing really is everything. And everything is, I think we've noticed too, like with so many things, it's all cyclical. So eventually things are just going to come back full circle and it'll be back.
I mean, we've noticed changes with, you know, Suspect 208. We've noticed changes with MGK, the crossovers. I mean, it's coming. It's just bringing it back to the limelight, which is going to happen. I think enough people are bitching that it's not happening, that it's going to happen.
And even more to that, breaking news as of today, even more fresh shit, the freshest shit, Alice Cooper took the number one spot on Billboard's top album sales chart with his new album, Detroit Stories. Which is like amazing. It's a top album sales chart ranks the top selling albums of the week based only on like traditional album sales. So it actually sold 13,000 copies across all formats just in the last week.
And that's fucking Billboard. Billboard is what every social media, every mainstream media, that's what they determine success from is Billboard. And he's number one on Billboard.
Number one, dude. It's amazing. See, we're really not worthy.
We're really not worthy.
Fucking scum, man. I love you, Alice.
I've seen Alice Cooper live several times. I am a huge Alice Cooper fan. I absolutely adore him. I adore everything that he stands for. He's a very wholesome and humble person as well, too.
Absolutely.
So. But I think that's about all all we really have for this episode. So, I mean, obviously, let us know what you guys think in the comments.
Do you guys really think rock is dead, or do you think it's just on life support right now?
Direct quote from Paul Stanley as well, too. Before we let you guys go, though, just do us a quick favor. Like, subscribe, hit the notification bell so you know when the episodes come out. Once again, I'm Candy.
And I'm B.
And that was a Trend Kill quickie. Bye, guys.
Thanks for joining. Bye.
Check, please.